Okay, can you hear this? Okay. There we go. Yeah, I'll be looking, yeah. Okay. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to United Presbyterian Church here in Yardville. We welcome everyone here in the congregation and all of you out there in internet land. And we're so glad that you could join us. I'm Don LaCrosse, substituting for Reverend Rob Morrison, who's been on vacation, and we're looking forward to him returning this coming Tuesday. And it is Valentine's Day, so happy Valentine's. We're here to celebrate the deepest of all the love that God has for us. And we are very pleased and blessed to have Pastor Samia Santos with us this morning to give us the message, and we're looking forward to that, so stay tuned. But then one other thing, after the benediction, all of you here don't leave, and all of you out there don't go away, because we have a special surprise. So that's coming. So for our call of worship this morning, we are going to have some responsive reading from Psalm 29. I'll read the leader part, and you all here and out there read the people part. So let's stand up for the reading of the word. Give unto the Lord, O you mighty ones. Give unto the Lord the glory due his name. The Lord will give strength to his people. Amen. Let's continue our worship with the singing of hymn 371, Lift High the Cross.
A heads up, obviously, Marilyn is not here this morning because of the ice, so we are going to be singing along with a YouTube video, so just roll with it, okay?
Thank you. God bless you, Meg.
Thank you.
Well, maybe it's been a little hard to follow the tune there, but I hope you got the words. They were majestic words. Lift high the cross of Jesus Christ. We also heard some beautiful words from the Psalms. Worship him in the beauty of holiness. I just love that phrase. Well, the day in glory when we will enter into the presence of the Holy of Holies. We can't do that now. Our Lord on that cross paved the way by taking all of our sin upon us. But we're in the process of transformation right now. We have the Lord's Spirit within us, but we still have the flesh dragging us down with sin. So we need a time to truly worship the Lord this morning, a time of confession, to have the Lord be honest with him and clean us and prepare us to enter into his presence further during this worship time. So let's say the call to confession together, and let's say it out loud, and we'll be followed with a time of silent prayer. Let's pray together. O Lord Jesus, we come to worship you this morning, but we confess that our lives often fall short of the worship you deserve. At times we have felt weak and did not turn to you for strength. During this time of COVID, we have found ourselves losing hope that it will ever end. We have not always believed that you are fully in control. We need you to increase our faith and build up our courage. We are totally dependent on your love and forgiveness. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray silently. Our dear wonderful Lord, we thank you that you have promised us in your word that if we confess our sins, you will be faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, I can proclaim to all of us, we are forgiven. Amen. Hallelujah. Now we are going to be blessed with a special dance team led by Maya Santos giving their rendition of Jesus Loves Me. Thank you. sing Jesus Loves Me, it's going to take on new meaning. Oh, thank you, girls. That was wonderful. Jesus said while he was on this earth, come to me, all you who are weak and burdened down, and I will give you rest. We have a time, all the time, that we can come to the Lord with anything that's burdening us. So we want a time of prayer right now for some of the burdens of our congregation and beyond. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Our dear loving Heavenly Father, we thank you so much that you promise that as we pray, you are interceding before the throne of grace and praying for us. So with confidence, we bring our concerns and our cares to you. Lord, we've lost some special folks in the recent days. And we pray for the family of Jenny Demeter and Bill Malloy and Vinnie Pinto. We pray that you will surround all of those families with your everlasting arms of love. In their grief, may they also cling on to the hope that their loved ones are with you in glory. We pray for those within our congregation and beyond that are struggling with cancer and going through radiation treatments. I'll be with them, dear Lord. Bring healing into them, but Lord, let them know your presence even during the unknown and during the pain. We pray also for the victims of COVID and those that have gone and suffered accidents in our congregation and those that are suffering with dementia and Alzheimer's. Dear Lord, in all of these cases, you love each one of these folks more than we can ever imagine. We thank you. We place them all in your hands. We give them to you for your safekeeping, for your eternal love and goodness. And now we thank you that you care about every aspect of our life and you care about our prayer life so much that you taught us how to pray. So we pray together the prayer that you taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. And now it's my great pleasure to turn the service over to Pastor Samuel. God bless you.
Thank you, Sister Megan. Whenever I come, usually because Pastor Rob is so much taller, like the mic is usually like up here, and I'm like, hello, everyone. thank you. I'm just gonna move it a little bit. I am so happy to be back here this morning. First of all, good morning. Good morning. It is such an amazing and great day for all of us to be able to celebrate together. Not only are we celebrating Christ like we do usually when we gather in our Sunday services for us, Vida Nueva is Saturday services, but the day of love, you know, the day that we recognize that great sacrifice that happened at that cross, what greater example of love is there, right? So I am very much honored to be able to celebrate this day with every single one of you, and please receive greetings from our church at Vida Nueva. Today I am accompanied by my forever Valentine, my husband of almost 21 years, and that is the glory of God right there. So my husband, Carlos, and my girls, Faith and Maya. Our deacon was supposed to be coming with her girls, and we do apologize because of the weather. She wasn't able to make it, but we are glad that she is okay. So today I just want to share a very quick meditation with you guys. If you just want to share this moment with us as well, and those of you watching us on internet land, that's what we called it this morning, on internet land. Good morning to you guys as well. But before I go on, can we just take a moment and pause and praise the Lord for these brave girls that just stood up this morning? Brave, brave girls. You know, when sometimes we're a little ashamed to walk around and say, like, you know what, I carry the love of God in my life, these two brave girls were like, you know what, I will be courageous and I will say thanks to the Lord, I am here tonight. So thank you. Thank you for allowing yourselves to be used by the Lord this morning and reminding us how great and loving our God is. So today I would like for you guys to please come with me to the book of John, chapter 3, verse 16. And I'm going to start off my message with a word that we all know. A lot of us already know this message, but if you could just come with me and journey with me. The book of John, chapter 3, verse 16. Says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Let us pray for a moment. My God, I thank you. Thank you so much, not only for today, God, but for that sacrifice that you have made in that cross, for sending your only Son to remind us, God, how much you love us. Lord, today as I stand here as your vessel, I ask you, Lord, that you please empty me completely of all of my nerves, all of my anxiety, of anything and everything that might prevent your Holy Spirit from flowing in this place tonight. Father God, I ask you that you empty me in such a way that every single word that comes out of my mouth today, may it not be one that comes out of my mind, but one that comes straight out of your heart and into every single one of my brothers and sisters' hearts today. In the name of Jesus, I thank you for all that you're doing in this season for a reason, and I bless your name, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray, amen. 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 So today, for all of you who are note takers like me, the message, I have titled it, The Greatest Treasure of All. And of course, it being, you know, the season of Valentine's, I'm wearing my little red so that I can represent a little bit. So we're gonna be talking about love, but not the type of love that you guys are thinking. We're gonna go a little bit more into the treasure of it. And as the Lord had given me this word, so then I can meditate a little bit more on it and share this message with you guys, I was sitting on my bed, and I was just meditating on the word, thinking about it, and just praying. And my girls were running in the background. They were just playing around. And I can hear my dog barking, chasing them around as well. It was just like a little bit chaotic. And my phone goes off. You know, like sometimes, I don't know if your phones do this, but sometimes they will vibrate and they will remind you of memories, picture memories that you might have taken throughout the years. So my phone began to vibrate with messages. And I opened it and I began to see pictures of my girls when they were little. And I'm trying not to get a little emotional right now, but it took me back to those moments when I was able to braid their hairs and they would allow me to do that. And whenever they wanted all of these dolls and all of these things, those simpler moments in life, you know. Now I have an adult. She's 20 years old, almost 21, and two young ladies who, truth be told, do not need as much of me anymore. But when I saw those pictures, it reminded me of why I would take these pictures all the time. Like, guys, please pose, click, click. Like, mom, we wanna go. No, just one more picture, one more picture. And not because I love to take pictures, but because I like to take those moments and just treasure them and keep them with me as much, as long as I can, because I know that they're gonna grow and they're gonna leave and they're gonna be doing their things, right? And I'm not gonna be able to hold on to them forever, even though I would love to do that. Truth be told, part of me is not ready yet. Like, I know my oldest is a nursing student and she's in college and she's almost ready to like leave the coop, as we call it. And I'm not ready for it. So when I was seeing these pictures and I was meditating and I was reading this word, it reminded me that even though I would never be able to understand that kind of love, I kind of sort of get it. when he sent his only son to die on a cross for us, I'll never understand that immense love. But the fact that fear that he couldn't bear to see us get lost in the world. He couldn't bear to see us suffer at the hands of the enemy. Us, his greatest treasure. We are his greatest treasure. He couldn't bear to see us cry and suffer in that way. So he sent his one and only son, the greatest sacrifice for us, just so he can hold on to us, so he can give us that hope that we could have a better future. Again, I'll never be able to understand, but I kind of sort of get it. So I was just going through those memories, and I was like, Lord, what are you trying to teach us in this season? As, you know, I'm there meditating and doing my thing. I don't have toddlers anymore. And I don't have to go around. I know that Sister Megan has three, and God bless you. And you're going to soon have to be like, do not touch that outlet. Do not touch the outlet. Do not touch the fire. I don't have to do that anymore. I know you do. So I don't have to be warning them in those, of those dangers. But I praise God for this season. But that greatest sacrifice, right? So as I was examining my heart, Jesus, as I was examining my heart, the Lord was asking me. I felt him asking my heart, what is your greatest treasure? And I was looking at the pictures, and the first thing that almost came into my mind, I was like, well, God, of course, it is my love for you, and it is my family. That is where my greatest treasure. And the Spirit was like, no, Sam, dig deeper, a little bit deeper. And I'm like, okay. And God and I have this weird relationship. He is my God, he is my Lord, but he's also my Abba, he's my Father, and at times he's my best friend. So I was gonna play that best friend's card, and I was gonna say, like, God, my greatest treasure is Woody. Woody is my dog. So Woody is my dog. And for one quick second, I was gonna play that card, because Lord knows that sometimes he's my favorite, and I tell him all the time, like, you are my favorite, like, you are my everything, and do not worry, my family has come to terms with this. They know they will be okay. So I was about to say, God, right after you and right after my family, they are, you know, Woody is my favorite, you know, and my greatest treasure. And the Spirit goes, Sam, dig deeper, a little bit deeper. And right there, I knew exactly where he wanted to go. You know, those greatest treasures. And as I was thinking about this and I was meditating on this, I was thinking very much like a pirate's kind of treasure. I was thinking of all of those things, those emotions, those memories, those feelings that we bury so deep in our hearts that we tend to forget. Those circumstances that we dig in, we bury them so, so deep that they kind of become one with us. And we don't think about them all the time, but circumstances sort of arise, and then we, you know, burst out in emotions, and then we realize why we act the way that we do. Those betrayals, those deepest hurts, that they become one with us, and we cannot always talk about them because they hurt so much. But yet we come to the cross all the time, and we're like, Lord, I cannot take this anymore, please take it. But our fists are closed, and we're like, here, but no thanks, I can't, I'm not ready for it yet. I was examining my heart, and when he said, dig deeper, I knew exactly where he was going, because we all have those moments. I don't think that any of us have lived the perfect life. I believe that all of us, you know, we have had those moments that we are very free to let go of some things, but other things we kind of tend to hold on to. You know, like when somebody lies to us, somebody hurts us, and, you know, there's that phrase out there, like, I will forgive you, but I cannot forget. When we do not forget, we hold that memory as a slave into our heart, a slave then digging in deep. That's where our treasure is. That's where our treasure is. And as I was listening, you know, and listening to the Holy Spirit in my heart, examining my heart, and, you know, truth be told, we always say, like the psalmist says, Lord, examine my heart and let it be as pure as snow. But is it really as pure as snow when we're holding on to these things that do not allow our hearts to shine through our actions the way that he would like for it to be. Those heartbreaking, heart-wrenching moments. Abandonment, perhaps. I don't know what it would be. I knew exactly where the Lord was taking me. But these things slowly, they poison our hearts, right? And they don't allow us to become the parents at times, the grandparents, the wives, the husbands, the sisters that the Lord wants us to be, because we're holding on to these things and we cannot express ourselves freely and love freely the way that the Lord wants us to love. Because truth be told, we're a little scared of getting hurt again. We're a little scared of being let down. We're a little scared of being betrayed by those who love us the most. Because truth be told, these greatest pains that we carry, those worst memories that stain our hearts, they're not caused by strangers in the streets. Sometimes they're caused by our loved ones. It happens. It happens. So as I was meditating on this, then he took me to the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 21. For where your treasure is, there your heart will also be. And it made me realize that our greatest treasures are not always those things that we meditate on the most. It could also be those things that we give the most attention to. I always say to our church, whenever we're talking and stuff, what are those things that you exchange God for? You know, sometimes we, you know, our church, we have meetings, we have prayer meetings, discipleship, which we meet online. I don't know if you guys do that. But sometimes, because we're human, sometimes we could be like, you know, I am going to watch this television program. And we switch on television programs instead of tuning into our prayer times or times that we know that we're supposed to be congregating and doing other things. We're human. It happens. What are those things that you'd rather be doing, that you focus your time and attention to, instead of giving that attention to God? Is it a soccer game? Is it a football game? Is it a baseball game? Is it a video game for my youngsters? What are those things that are consuming your most attention? Let's start examining what is our greatest treasure. I know this has not happened here, and you know, Vida Nueva does not happen either. But sometimes we even place COVID as an excuse not to come to church. When truth be told, and again, this has not happened here, this is not here, this is not in Vida Nueva, it could be like many other churches out there. But sometimes we place COVID as an excuse, as a reason not to congregate. When truth be told, we go to many other places. We meet with many other friends. We go shopping, we go out to eat, we do many other things. But we cannot come to the house of the Lord because we're a little scared of COVID. You get what I'm saying? And I say that with the utmost love and respect. Again, this is not happening here. But what are we placing before the Lord? Sometimes we'll stay home, not because of COVID, but because it is just a little bit more comfortable for us to stay home. Have you noticed how sometimes that greatest comfort zone could also be your greatest treasure? Our comfort zones, those areas that just keep us still, keep us paralyzed. I just feel so good right now, I just don't wanna shift. Like, I don't wanna go anywhere. Like, Lord, I love you, but here. I am good here, and I am good right now. When the Lord is calling you in this season for a reason, to be the love that he needs outside in that world that is calling out, crying out for hope, crying out for somebody to give those words that you know, hug, even if it's just kind of like this, you know, or like a hey, high five, or a smile underneath our masks, our smize, as you know they call it in the modeling world, a smize. That could change somebody else's life, but we're too comfortable. We're too comfortable. What is our greatest treasure? What is keeping us still? What is keeping us still in this moment? If I could just tap back in very quickly. If I could just tap in very quickly into those truths that we were talking about before. Because sometimes we carry masks. Sometimes we carry masks because we're a little too afraid of getting exposed. truth be told, I've carried masks for quite a while, but I am also very open about the hurts inside of me. I have shared with you guys a little bit before about my past, and truth be told, sometimes when I talk about it, I still get a little emotional, if you can hear it in my voice. But sometimes when I hear the word dad, it hurts because mine wasn't there. You get me? That's where our greatest treasure is. Where that pirate's treasure. I had to like really search inside my heart when the Lord said search deeper. I really felt like I was carrying a pirate's map, like where do I go next? Because sometimes we bury these things very, very deep inside. And as he was telling me to dig deeper, I realized that he was talking about abandonment issues that we carry deep inside. And because of these abandonment issues, because of these betrayals, because of these hurts, we cannot love our husbands the way that he called us to love. We cannot love our wives the way that he called us to love, or even our children, because we're a little scared. So we carry a mask and we smile and we say that everything is okay. But we do not love the way that the Lord wants us to love, because we're a little scared of letting go. And we say, Lord, you're in our hearts today, you know, and we love you and we praise you for all that you have done. Lord, I cannot carry this burden anymore. Just kind of like take it. But no, thanks. I'm not quite ready yet. Am I the only one that's ever happened to? Am I the only human? Thank you, Sister Megan. As I was examining that, and I was like, Lord, I am your child, completely imperfect. And I know that you're dealing in my heart and in my life so that I can become that vessel of love. Lord, allow me to become that mother that you want me to be and love freely. And as I was doing that, he said, but Samia, you have to dig deeper. What is holding you back from loving others the way that you were called to love? What is holding each of us back from loving the way that God called us to love? What is holding you back? What is holding your greatest attention? Is it perhaps fear of something? Is it perhaps, like I said before, abandonment? You know, perhaps if I would have asked you at the beginning of the service, or perhaps if I still ask you now, what is your greatest treasure? Perhaps some of you might say to me, it is my family. And that is A-okay. But for other people, it is not quite so lovely. For other people, the things that they treasure the most are those assaults that they have suffered, are those pains that they carry deep inside, which do not allow them to sleep well at night. I am a life coach as part of my living, and I'm also a psychology student, and as part of, you know, everything that I do, I have realized so much so the power that our thoughts and our emotions have over our bodies. And as I am coaching our ladies and the people that I have, sometimes they'll tell me, like, I want to do this, but I am battling this illness and this illness and this illness and this illness. And then I would say, let's dig deeper, sort of like the Holy Spirit was telling me. And then we will come to realize that sometimes, a lot of the times, like, did you know that your mind and your heart have so much power over your bodies, that we have illnesses that are linked to it, whether it is high blood pressure, heart issues, intestinal issues, like all of these nervous and body issues that we battle with at times, they are linked to those emotions and those thoughts that we carry, and we carry as a burden deep inside, and because we're not able to let go of, they have poisoned part of who we are, kind of becoming deep inside one of us and not allowing us to not only express ourselves fully, but we can't even function fully in life. Am I the only one? I would battle, I'm thinking in Spanish, I'm trying to translate into English at the same time, but like ulcers, stomach ulcers, which a lot of people say, ooh, are you too stressed out? Yes. Because we're holding on to things that do not belong to us. Holding on to stressors that should belong in that cross, But we're like, Lord, I need to do and I cannot let go. And I just want to macro do absolutely everything because I cannot trust that everybody else will do everything that I need to do. And then we bury our bodies to the ground. What is your greatest treasure? What are you giving your most attention to? As I wrap up this message, and I know that the Lord is speaking to some, examining our hearts, I would like for you to just take a moment and please be on your feet for 2 moments with me, if you could just be on your feet. Like I said before, to some, greatest treasure are families, but to others, it is not so lovely. To others, greatest treasure is a lot of pain. And as a church, we are here not only to be able to help those find the light and the love that the Lord freely has for every single one of us, but we also need to recognize that we cannot be the help that the world needs if we do not heal those areas inside of our hearts first. So today, I would like to unite as brothers and sisters and come to God and have him examine our hearts. Have him examine every single part of us that is perhaps holding us back from becoming that greatest love out there, his light out there. When the Lord sent his only son to die in that cross for you and me, for Sister Wendy, for Sister Marilyn, who isn't here, but I'm sure she is watching, Sister Megan, every single one of us, he did the greatest sacrifice because you were his greatest treasure. He died on that cross for you because you were his greatest treasure. He couldn't bear to see you get lost. He couldn't bear to see you suffer. What is holding you back? What is holding you back? What is your greatest treasure today? Lord, as we come before you, Father, and we examine our hearts today, Lord, Valentine's Day, the day of love, the day of hope, the day of friendship. But truth be told, a lot of us are perhaps not able to shine that love the way that you intend for us, because perhaps there are a few areas in our hearts that need to be further examined and cleansed by you. But if we're a little honest, God, we know what those areas are. And it's a little hard for us to let go because we're human. And perhaps, God, it might take a little bit of a spiritual surgery. So if that is what it takes, God, today we surrender our minds. Father God, today we surrender our hearts. We surrender every single part of us freely, God. And we ask you, Lord, to please do the spiritual surgery in us, to work in us and through us, and do like the psalmist said in the book of Psalms, and create and make our hearts as pure as snow. To make it so pure, God, that whenever we're walking in the streets or whenever we're speaking to anybody on the phone or wherever it may be, your love will be able to radiate freely through every single one of our words and our actions, God. Cleanse us, Father. Cleanse us in such a way that these memories, these hurts, will no longer have a negative power over us. But instead, Father, you will be able to turn these around for your glory. And we will be able to testify, Father, that yes, we were a little hurt, but you were able to heal our hearts. And we are now walking testimony of what your power can do to restore and amend all love. Father God, as we walk around, I ask you, Lord, that you give us the strength that we need and the courage so that when we are out there, Father, we will be able to walk and love the way that 1 Corinthians 13 says, Father, without envy, without fear, just loving freely, God. Help us, Lord, to become that vessel of hope and love that the world needs. I believe, God, that we are not here in coincidence. I believe, God, that you have called us in this season for a reason. And this world is in so much need of you today. So I ask you, Lord, to please help us so that we can become those vessels of love in your name. In the name of Jesus, I praise you. I praise your name for all that you have done, all that you are doing, and all that you will continue to do. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Amen.
You can all be seated. Well, praise the Lord. I hope you were touched the way I was. I felt the Lord coming right at me. And thank you so much, Pastor Samuel. I realized that we skipped over the announcements earlier on, so I want to just point out a few of what's coming up in the church. Our pastor is coming back on Tuesday, and at that same time will be the funeral for Jenny Demeter. And we want to pray for the family at that time. And on Wednesday, the 17th, in a couple weeks, we're going to have an Ash Wednesday service. So we invite you to participate with the pastor. And then that following Sunday, the 21st, we're going to ordain and install the new elders or the returning elders and deacons to our church. And so we look forward to those events coming up. We have a time of giving thanks in many different ways. And one way that we give thanks is to give back to the Lord a little bit that he's given to us monetarily. So we have an opportunity to give here in the church, in the sanctuary if you're here. If you want to mail in your tithes and offerings, or you can go to our website, and we appreciate anything that you give. So we want to dedicate all that has been given and is being given to the Lord right now. Let's pray. Our dear loving Heavenly Father, you gave us the greatest gift of all, that of your Son, Jesus Christ, and we thank you. And Father, we just ask now that these gifts that we give back to you will be used in your service to spread the gospel, to reach out to the needy, the hurting, and all will be done to your honor and glory. We pray all this in Jesus' precious and holy name. Amen. Now we're going to sing, I guess with music, I've Got Peace Like a River. And if we are putting all of our stresses, our lack of forgiveness, and everything that Pastor Samuel talked about up on that cross, we're going to feel it more, peace like a river. So let's sing together.
Okay, we could do this. There we go. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. My God, today we thank you. Thank you so much for what an amazing blessing it is, Father, for us to be able to come together in unity and celebrate that love that you have given to every single one of us. Be reminded, Father, of that great sacrifice that you had made by sending your only son to die on that cross for us. We praise you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all that you're doing in us and through us. I ask you, Father, that as we wrap up our service today, Father, may you send your Holy Spirit to continue to examine our hearts, Lord, and remind us, Lord, at all times that you are that greatest example of love that there is. Father, please be with my brothers and sisters at home. We declare, Father, that there is healing for those who are sick. And we declare, Father, that you will be helping also to drive safely back home or wherever each of their destinations are. And they will be able to be blessed and safe wherever our brothers and sisters may go. Thank you, God, once again for all that you are doing in this season. Because we know that it is for a reason. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Everyone wants to hang out for just a minute. There's a Valentine's Day surprise from Rev Rob. He's not here, but he has sent along a bit of a surprise. And if you check out back there, there's the surprise.